It is best estimated that the initial North American inhabitants migrated from Asia during the last ice age, probably between 30,000 and 11,000 years before the Common Era. A land bridge formed through the Bering Strait between Russia and Alaska. In all likelihood, they were hunters and gatherers, and they were following large game. So they walked where an ocean will be in pursuit of mammoth and bison and horses. Eventually, though, that food source all vanished. Around 5,000 years before the Common Era, the ancient Americans began cultivating maize or corn. This led to an initially stronger population south of modern-day Texas because of the more advantageous climate. It was still too cold north of the Rio Grande to sustain much human life. Because agriculture was unreliable, because of the chilled climate, the ancient Americans had to generally rely upon two of the three following food sources: hunting, gathering, and whatever they could consistently control with agriculture. Because the climate was warmer in the Southwest, the first sedentary people settled in the American Southwest. This was first recognized with the Hohokam and Anasazi cultures. Around 1500 in the Common Era, the Spanish identified people in the Southwest they referred to as Pueblo because of their pit houses and cliff dwellings. With these, they constructed planned villages that involved multi-storied buildings with terraces and many rooms. These served defensive purposes as well as civic development. By the time the Spanish arrived, they had developed irrigation techniques and were also skilled with ceramics and weaving. Gradually, the ice retreated, and the rest of the North American continent would become populated as the ability to sustain with agriculture changed many cultures. The three most prevalent would be the Edina, Hopewell, and Mississippi cultures. All of these would be structured around farming and emphasize religious practices. European settlers would be blown away by the mounds and earthworks that they had constructed for religious purposes. They were also so complex, the Europeans believed they had to have been set up by a non-native civilization. They thought the Native Americans were too primitive to have constructed them. The Edina were noted for their respect for the dead, which they demonstrated throughout their mounds and earthworks. The most famous of these was the Great Serpent Mound. In Ohio alone, there were more than 10,000 mounds constructed. Archaeologists suspect that these were constructed to help the dead in the afterlife. These conclusions were based off of such items as pipes having been left in them. Some of these have merely been for defensive purposes as well. One of these was 3.5 miles long and enclosed about 100 acres. This would be big enough to protect 50 city blocks or 2.5 square miles. There is also evidence that the Edina were part of a complex trading network. This would be advanced through the Hopewell further. They left evidence of elevated structures, which seemed to suggest they had greater population density. They also left more advanced mounds that provided evidence that their trade network was continental. Within the mounds, they had left obsidian from the Rocky Mountains. There was also copper from as far away as Lake Michigan, and some also had conch from Florida. Within their urban settlements, they had mastered pottery and developed copper tools as well. Their disappearance was a curiosity, though. It seems as if they had suffered some agricultural disturbances that made it impossible to have the same dense population. By about 600 in the Common Era, final Hopewell capital was built in Cahokia, or modern-day St. Louis, in East St. Louis. Cahokia may have been housed by 20,000 people and served as a hub for many surrounding villages. There is also evidence that it was part of a trade network that spanned as far north as Wisconsin, as far south as Louisiana, as far east as Tennessee, and as far west as Oklahoma. Finally, the most recent culture was the Mississippian. Their evidence suggests that they were completely reliant upon agriculture, developing maize and beans. Archaeologists believe that they may have a direct relationship to those who would eventually settle in Mesoamerica. Much of that is guesswork, though. By the time Europeans arrived in the 17th century, most of these cultures, including Cahokia, had been completely abandoned, and the only people who were left had no idea what happened to the original occupants.